केसरिणः स्वच्छस्वच्छाय आयासित इन्दवः त्रायन्ताम्बूमधुरिपोः प्रपन्नार्तिच्छिदो नखाः. We were looking at how bhakti or lakshana cannot be a lakshanam, definition of dhvani. Ativyaptehe atha avyaptehe cha asau lakshyate taya. So, na cha asau lakshyate taya. Taya bhaktya athava lakshanaya dhvanihi na lakshyate. So we cannot define dhvani based on lakshana because of these two faults, like ativyapti and avyapti. Ativyapti means alakshye lakshana sattvam. Avyaptihi is lakshya ekadesha vrittitvam. For ativyapti, he gives us five examples. Avyapti, he does not give much, any example at all in Karika. So he just takes it that we will understand it. So let's look at the five examples that he gives for ativyapti. Ativyapti is where lakshana, in these shlokas, you have lakshana, but you do not have dhvani. Parimlanam peenastana jagana sangad upayataha tanor madhyasyantaha parimilanam apraapya haritam idam vyastanyasam shlata bhuja latakshepa valanaihi krishangyaha santapam vadati visini patra shayanam. This is a shlokam from Ratnavali where Udena describes so Sagarika is undergoing the virahatapam. So she is been lying down on a shayanam, and that shayanam shows her santapam. So that's the idea of the shlokam. It describes how that bed is. The bed is made of all lotus leaves and flowers, things that which will make her body cool. Peenastana jaghana sangat ubhayataha parimlanam. So where her hips and her breasts were, those two places are parimlanam. The leaves are all very faded, and the other places it is madhyasya antaha parimilanam aprapya haritam. It is still, the leaves are still green in places where her body has not come into contact. Tanoho madhyasya. So tanoho madhyasya antaha, tanu har shariram, sharirasya madhyasya antarbhage parimilanam aprapya. Because it is, she's got a very slender waist, the bed has not come into contact with her middle portion of the body, and hence the leaves are all still haritam. They have not turned or they have not faded. Shlatha buja lata akshepa valanaihi vyastanyasam. Some of the, see, when you first arrange that bed for the woman who is in viraham, so it will be arranged in a proper manner, but she is not able to tolerate that fever or that tapam that is there, manmatha madana kama tapam that is there in her body. So she moves her hands here and there. Shlatha buja lata. It's not a, so if she had just kept her arms in a very proper manner, then it's okay. But her arms do not have any strength. So it is shlatha. It's very weak. So you just she just threw her arms this way and that way. So shlatha bhujalata akshepa, by throwing valanaihi vyastanyasam. Arrangement has been mixed, or it is disarray. It is, the whole bed is in a disarray in certain places where her hands would have shaken the whole thing. So idam bisini patra shayanam, this lotus, this shayanam which is made of bisini patram, lotus leaves, krishangyaha santapam vadati. It shows the slender girl's santapam. So I just explained it as shows, but it actually, the literal meaning here is santapam vadati. Vadati is actually something you say with the clear words. Vyaktayam vachi is only vadu datoho. Vadu vyaktayam vachi. So vyakta aksharam means you have to use clear words. Now here the vachyartham is actually using clear words. Can a bed speak using clear words? No, it cannot. So then the vachyartha bada happens, mukhyartha bada. The primary meaning is negated or you remove that primary meaning, you go to the lakshyartha where you say it shows or prakati karoti is phuti karoti, then that is the lakshyartham that we go to, suchayati. Here there is no prayojanam. There is, we only know by popular convention that when people say, you know, it just says what his action speaks. His action will never speak. Action only shows something. So it is accepted by popular convention that vadati can also mean suchayati. And it is a rudhi mula lakshana where there is no prayojanam for that, for negating the vachyartham and going to the lakshyartham. So here there is no dhvani, there is only lakshana here. Next is the second, these are all very simple examples where there is no dhvani, or even if there exists a dhvani, the dhvani does not have any chamatkaram. Next one is tatha shatakrutvo avarudhyate sahasrakrutvaha chumbyate viramya punaramyate priyaha janaha nasti punaruktam. A nayika is talking about how a nayika behaves. Shatakrutvaha avarudhyate, he embraces her 100 times, and sahasrakrutvaha chumbyate, the priya is being, or she is being kissed 1,000 times, viramya, and then he stops, punaramyate, he continues to enjoy with her, tadrishaha priyaha janaha, this is actually a nayika, nasti punaruktam. So the priyaha janaha is only the nayika, not the nayakaha. So priyaha janaha shatakrutvaha avarudhyate, the beloved is being embraced 100 times, kissed 1,000 times, and she is being enjoyed for some time and then stopped and then again. So it seems as if there is a repetition, but what he says is nasti atra punaruktam, there is no repetition here. Now punaha uktam, again this, just like the previous example, we have vad dhatu here. So punaruktam again would mean muhur muhu vyaktaksharam upayuktam. That is not the case here. It is just an action that is being repeated. And if he just, even though he repeats the action, same action again and again, chumbanadi kriyasu punaruktasya asambhavat, the punaha kritam eva atra lakshyartaha. So he does it again and again. That is what is the lakshyartha, intended meaning here. Whereas the literal meaning is, he said it, he repeatedly said, that is the literal meaning, but that the mukhyartha bada here happens and you go to the lakshyartha. Here also there is no dhvani, but it is only lakshana. Next example is, kupitaha prasannaha avarudita vadanaha vihasantyaha yatha grihitaha tatha hridayam haranti. Swairinyaha mahilaha. Swairinyaha mahilaha. Swairinyaha mahila or abhisarika, a lady who approaches her beloved. So this is an abhisarika. Mahilaha can just mean women, but Lochanakara takes it as an abhisarika also. So swairini is a person who goes on her own, who approaches the nayaka on her own. So swairinyaha mahilaha yatha grihitaha kupitaha prasannaha avarudita vadanaha vihasantyaha va yatha grihitaha tatha hridayam haranti. They are so attractive, however they may present their attitude, in whatever attitude they may be, whether they are angry, kupitaha, prasannaha, whether they are happy, or avarudita vadanaha, or if they are crying, vihasantyaha, if they are laughing out loud. Prasanna is just Tamil mukham malarndu irukkiradhu, adu prasanna. So it is just a very calm and peaceful face. So kupita is angry, whereas prasanna is a calm, peaceful face. Avarudita vadanaha, crying, vihasantyaha, they are laughing out loud. In any manner, yatha grihitaha, however they are received, tatha hridayam haranti. So here grihita, hridayam haranti means they are attractive to the mind. the literal meaning of grihita and haranti, grihitaha means grahanam, you take or you capture, you take their face. So however you take those ladies, that is the literal meaning here. Whereas you cannot mukha grahanam sakshat kartum na shakyate. Tasmat lakshyarthe upadanam athava maybe understanding, you can say jnanam is a better way to look at it. So the moment you look at them, so grahanam is vishayikaranam, maybe a better way to understand. Instead of upadanam is vishayikaranam. However you understand them, or however you they present a face to you, yatha grihitaha hridayam haranti. Haranti also means like something like thieving. You steal away the heart. You cannot steal someone's heart literally. So you discount the literal meaning and you take the lakshya artham, which is akarshanam or attraction. Chitta apaharanam means it's not like vitta apaharanam. It's not like stealing any money. But if you are stealing the heart, you use that expression even in English or any other language, stealing one's heart. Chitta chor, no? In Hindi also we say. Nobody can, you can't steal the heart like that. So it is a metaphorical representation of attraction. So akarshanam. Here also there is no dhvani, or even if there is a dhvani, it is not chamatkara yukta. Okay. Next example, bharyayaha praharaha navalataya dattaha priyena stanaprishthe mridukaha abhi dussahaha iva jataha hridaye sapatninam. So bharyayaha stanaprishthe priyena navalataya praharaha dattaha. When the lover hit his wife on her bosoms with a new creeper, which is a young creeper, navalataya, bharyayaha stanaprishte, on her stanam, priyena praharaha dattaha, he hit her. Not hit, that is not a literal meaning, is danam, prahara, danam, he gave a beating, or how can I say that? So praharaha, prahara danam is aprasiddham, so it is just a tap, sort of a tap. So mridukaha api, even though it was soft, sapatninam hridaye dussahaha jataha iva. It was as if the other wives of him could not tolerate this. So this is a sign of the Nayaka showing his love for the new wife, or showing love for one of the wives, when the other wives are feeling jealous about this. So they are unable to tolerate this action of his, even though that action is a very soft one. So it just shows that irshya, asuya is the dhvani here, but that is not chamatkaram as much as the mridukopi dussahaha iva jataha hridaye sapatnina. Even though it was soft, it was tough for the sapatni to tolerate it. They could not tolerate that. So atrapi danam dattaha ityatra danam iti vachyarthaha tasya badaha. You don't give prahara or beating in charity. Nobody wants such a thing as a charity. Danam is yad swasya swayatte yad asti tat anya ayattam swa swamitvam. You are transferring the ownership to someone else. That is danam. That's the actual meaning of danam. So here, that will never fit here. So mukhyartha badaha, and you only take it as prahara vidhanam or praharaha krithaha. Here also there is no dvani and it is only lakshana. The last shlokam that he gives as an example is pararthe yav pidam anubhavati bhangepi madhuraha yadiyaha sarvesham ihakhalu vikaropi abhimataha na sampraptaha vriddhim yadi sabhrisham akshetrapatitaha kim ikshor dosho asau na punaha agunayaha marubhuvaha kim ikshor dosho asau na punar agunayaha marubhuvaha. Pararthe yaha pida marubhavati. This is a description of a sugar cane. How we process the sugar cane and take juice out of it. So pararthe यः इक्षुदण्डः पीडाम् अनुभवति, इट् अण्डर्गोस् टार्चर्, इट् एक्स्पीरियन्सेस् पीडा. सो हियर् इट् सेल्फ् वी हेव् अ वाच्यार्थं विच् विल् नाट् फिट् फार् दि इक्षुदण्ड, बिकास् इक्षुदण्डम् इस् अचेतन वस्तु एण्ड् इट् केनाट् एक्स्पीरियन्स् अ पीडा टार्चर्. सो वि टेक् इट् एस् जस्ट् क्रशिङ्ग् द इक्षुदण्डम्. सो निष्पेषः एव अत्र लक्ष्यार्थः. सो देट् पार्ट् इस् ओवर्. I'll just give you a small brief meaning of that shlokam. So pararthe anyasya arthe yaha ikshudandaha peedam anubhavati bhangevi madhuraha. Even when you break it into two, it is very sweet. So sometimes you break it and you can eat it directly also. So bhange api, even if you break someone, whereas if you compare it with manushyaha, when someone undergoes too much of difficulties in life, they come out bitter. Not many people will have the courage to face things with a very so if I tell you, you have to undergo this torture for someone else, someone has to do it, but you have to sacrifice your life for them, not many people will be willing to do that in life. But this ikshudandam is like an example for how we have to live in life. Bhangepi maduraha, when your spirit is broken, no one is sweet to others, they only reflect bitter things in life. So bhangepi maduraha, even though you lose your spirit, you are broken in life, you don't lose your spirit, you are still sweet. That's the advice that we get from this. So yadiyaha sarvesham iha kalu vikaraha api abhimataha, yadiyaha vikaraha तद् इक्षुदण्डीयः विकारः अपि सर्वेषाम् अभिमतः. द विकारः वेन् यु कन्वर्ट् दि इक्षुदण्ड इन् टु डिफ्रेण्ट् टैप्स् आफ् विकारम्, इट् अण्डर्गोस् डिफ्रेण्ट् चेञ्जस् एण्ड् ईवन् द चेञ्ज् इस् सूटबल् फार् अस्. वि लैक् द चेञ्जस् दट् वि दट् कम् अबौट् फ्रम् इट्. वाट् आर् आल् द चेञ्जस् वित् शुगर्, जागरि, आर् जस्ट् मियर् ज्यूस्? Anything, any sort of vikaram that is there from the, that we get, the new transformation that happens for that ikshudanda is also abhimataha ishtaha eva. Na samprapto vriddhim yadi saha brisham akshetrapatitaha. So vikaraha api abhimataha, if someone changes their attitude, it is not abhimatam. Someone who is very nice today, tomorrow they come and just scold you. We don't like it. Even if it is a person we see every day, we want them to be nice and sweet and, you know, not shout at us or however. So that vikaraha tu sarvada na abhimataha, parantu ikshudandasya vikaraha sarvesham api abhimataha eva. Sarva vidha vikaraha, in any manner that it changes, even the chakka and gramulyu, what is that? And the, after you remove that ghanras, you have that thing that is also useful. So there is a use for every part of that sugar cane. So yadi vriddhim na sampraptaha, if it does not grow, or if one does not attain prosperity, it is because akshetrapatitaha. It is, if it does not grow, it means it is not been sowed in the correct field. The field in which it has been sowed is not proper, it is not appropriate. So if a nice person has not gained a good prosperity, then it means the place or the surrounding or the ambience in which he grows is not good. Any child who is born is always born good. Of course, the samskara visheshaha is always there, but any sort of samskara vishesham can be changed with the ambience that he grows up in. Very important. So akshetra patitaha brisham saha kim ikshoho the doshaha aso na punar agunayaha marubhavaha. Or you can also say ikshoho doshaha na aso agunayaha marubhavaha eva doshaha. You go and try to sow a sugar cane in a desert, it is not going to grow. It's not the fault of the ikshudandam, but it is the fault of the marubhavaha, marubhuhu, the desert, which has agunam, which has no qualities. It does not have the necessary nutrients and the qualities that a soil needs, for that the sugarcane needs in a soil for it to grow. सो न सम्प्राप्तः वृद्धिं यदि स भृशम् अक्षेत्रपतितः. दिस् अ वेरि नैस् श्लोकम्. दट् इस् नाट् मेनी आफ् द नीतिशतक श्लोकास् आर् आल्सो लैक् दिस् ओन्ली, बट् देर् इट् इस् मोर् आफ् अ लक्षण देन् दि व्यङ्ग्यार्थ. सो द व्यङ्ग्यार्थम् इस् in how someone explains and tries to applies it. Even then, when you keep coming back to this Ikshudandam and you say how beautiful he is, the imagery is so beautiful here, that becomes much more chamatkara yuktam. So ityatra ikshupakshe anubhavati shabdaha. So anubhavati is a word which is associated with chetanatvam, any person who has a consciousness. हियर् अचेतनवस्तु इक्षुदण्डस्य अचेतनत्वात् लक्ष्यार्थः निष्पेषः. ओके, नौ उक्तेषु उदाहरणेषु न च एवंविधः कदाचिदपि ध्वनेः विषयः. इन् आल् द एक्साम्पल्स् दट् वी हेव् सेड् ध्वनिविषयः, इट् इस् नाट् ए ध्वनिविषय. देर् इस् नो ध्वनि इन् एनी आफ् दीस् फैव् एक्साम्पल्स् बिकास् यतः उक्त्यन्तरेण अशक्यं यत् चलु.
वाट् इस् दिस् एवं विधः?
एवं विधः पूर्वोक्तविधः उदाहरणं. न च एवं विधः, एवं विधः पुल्लिङ्गत्लये केत्रया
पूर्यते
पूर्यते. एवं विधः शब्दः नडतुको इल्लया. एवं विधः शब्दप्रयोगः कदाचित् ध्वनेर्विषयः न भवति. यतः बिकास् उक्त्यन्तरेण अशक्यं यत् तच्चारुत्वं प्रकाशयन् शब्दो व्यञ्जकतां बिभ्रत् ध्वन्युक्तेः विषयी भवेत्. नेक्स्ट् कारिका. अत्र च उदाहृते विषये न उक्त्यन्तर अशक्यचारुत्वव्यक्तिहेतुः शब्दः. सो उक्त्यन्तरेण अशक्यम्, उक्त्यन्तरेण ध्वनि व्यतिरिक्तेन शब्दव्यापारेण अभिधाव्यापाराः अथवा लक्षणाव्यापारेण, अभिधाव्यापारेण लक्षणाव्यापारेण वा यत् चारुत्वं प्रकाशयितुं न शक्यम्. वि आर् अनेबल् टु द ब्यूटि दट् केनाट् बि एक्स्प्रेस्ड् बै एनी अदर् व्यापार अदर् देन् व्यञ्जनाव्यापार. So, a charutvam or a chamatkaratvam that cannot be expressed by abhidha and that which cannot be expressed by lakshana, tadrishaha shabdaha vyanjakatam bibhrat, it takes on the identity of a vyanjaka. It becomes a suggester. So, vyanjana vyaparam bibhrat dharayan dharan dhvani uktehe vishayi bhavet sa shabdaha dhvani uktehe. So that word which carries a vyanjana vyapara, that word which is capable of giving me a charutvam which cannot be expressed by any other vyapara like lakshana or abhida, that shabda becomes vyanjaka, it becomes a suggester, which means vyanjakatam bibhrat, vyanjana vyaparam bibhrat sat, san dhvanyuktehe vishayi bhavet, only that is called dhvani. So atracha udahrute vishaye, in the five examples that we saw before, uktyantara ashakya charutva vyakti hetuhu shabdaha na asti. So each of those words that we saw in Parimlanam, we saw vadati, punaruktam, praharaha dattaha, grihitaha, and then harati. In the last one we saw anubhavati. All of these words, it is not by any other method that we find the meaning. Anubhavati ityatra nishpeshaha, what is the, how did we get to that meaning? It is not through vyanjana vyaparam. Anubhavati does not fit. So there is a mukhyartha badha. And then you find out what can come in this context and say it is anubhavaha or peshanam is the meaning that you have to come about. So either it is by popular convention or you have a prayojanam there. One or the two should be there. But there is a mukhyartha badha where the primary meaning does not fit with the sentence. Okay, so uktyantara ashakya charutva vyakti hetuhu. So this shabdam, the word the it is not capable, it is not a reason. The word is not a reason for giving me or expressing the charutvam. It's just in a translation of that shlokam, that's all. It's better to read the shlokam itself to get this, for me to translate this entire visheshanam is very difficult. So, anya vyaparena yate charutvam prakashayitum na shakyam tadrisha charutva vyakti. To express that vyakti hetuhu shabdaha na asti purvokta udaharaneshu. Now, so that in why he brings about this is, so there can be places where Lakshana has a prayojanam. So if that, like in Gangayam Goshaha, we have Gangayam Goshaha Ganga Shabdasya Pravahaha Vachyartaha Pravahe Ghoshasya Asatvat Mukhyarthasya Badhaha Bhavati Tadanantaram Samipyat Lakshyarthasya Prakashanam. So that Lakshyartham that we take goes through a process of Mukhyarthabada and then Yoga. Mukhyarthabade Tadyoge Ruditota Prayojanat, you must have read in Kavya Prakasham. So that is the process that Lakshana takes. Whereas in Dhvani, and now after all this process and you go to the Lakshyartham of Ganga Tate Ghoshaha. Now, why did he use Gangayam Ghoshaha in the first place? It was because there is a Prayojanam for that, which is Pavanatvam Shaityam. That Pavanatvam Shaityam involves Vyanjana Vyapara. Okay? So, if this sort of a Prayojanam can exist even in some of those shlokas, like in Pararthe, Yav Pidam Anubhavati, the prayojanam there would be to, you know, to connect with chetanatvam. Chetanatva aropartham. You can say something like that. So, but in other words, if there is a prayojanam, then it can be dhvani vishayaha. But only it can be a dhvani vishayam only if there is a charutvam. But none of those shlokas that we saw, even saprayojana lakshana api tatra charutvam nasti iti karanat dhvanir vishayaha. Okay. Next is rudhi hetu. So kincha, even in rudhi stalam, what is rudhi means? There is a literal meaning and then there is a suggested meaning. And that literal meaning, the words are never used in their literal sense. They're only used in the lakshyartha, which has been fixed by popular convention. So, rudhaye vishaye anyatra shabdaha sva vishayadapi lavanyadya prayuktaha te na bhavanti padam dhvanehe. Even there, you can say lavanyadyaha shabdaha. So, lavanyam is an example that you take. What is lavanyam? Lavanasya bhavaha, lavana rasa yuktam. That is the literal etymological meaning of that. Not literal, but etymological. But by popular convention, Lavanya has not been used in that sense. It is completely removed from its etymological derivation. So, ye shabdaha lavanyadhyaha sva vishayat sva arthat lavana rasa yuktam ityadi arthat anyatra. So lavanyam is an exceptional quality that cannot be described or which is attractive to the mind. Manoharatvam, hridyatvam, these are the ideas that we get in our mind as soon as we hear the word lavanyam. The same way kushalaha. Kushalaha is a word used for to indicate a person who is an expert. So the etymological derivation of that is kushana lati, one who cuts grass. So nobody uses saha kushalaha, doesn't mean that he goes and cuts grass every day. We don't use it today in that sense. So by popular convention, the word kushalaha has come to mean someone who is an expert in his area. So that is completely removed from its vishayam, sva vishayat, sva arthat, from its etymological derivation. Okay, so ye रूढाः लावण्याद्याः ये शब्दाः ये स्वविषयात् अन्यत्र प्रयुक्ताः रूढाः शब्दाः ते ध्वनेः पदं न भवन्ति. सो ये दोस् वर्ड्स् स्वविषयात् अन्यत्र दोस् विच् हेव् बीन् यूस्ड् एल्स्वेर् प्रयुक्ताः अवे फ्रम् देर् डिरैवेशन् तादृशलावण्याद्याः शब्दाः ध्वनेः पदं न भवन्ति. दे आर् आल्सो नाट् ध्वनिविषयम्. तेषु च उपचरितवृत्तिः, उपचरितशब्दवृत्तिः मीन्स् उपचरित शब्दवृत्तिः उपचरित गौणीभूत द शब्दवृत्ति आर् द प्रैमरि मीनिङ्ग् एटिमलाजिकल् डिरैवेशन् हेस् बीन् इस् अप्रधानम् आर् इट् इस् कम्प्लीट्लि लेट् गो, इट् इस् अबेण्डन्ड् and we take only the lakshyartham. So upacharita shabda vrittihi asti iti tatha vije vidhe cha visaye kvachit sambhavan api dhvani vyavaharaha prakarantarena pravartate na tatha vidha shabda mukhena tatha vide visaye. Even in places where we use words like, there are many shlokams where we use lavanyam. There is a Prakrit line that is given in Lochanam. I can't find a Sanskritam version of it, nor can I understand Prakritam. So it's difficult for me to give an example of where Tatha Vide Vishaye, in such examples where there could be a Dvani Vyavaharam. But so we use, say for example, we use Kushala, the word Kushalam or Lavanyam in a Shlokam where there is an Adbhuta Dvani. But that dhvani does not come from this shabda. Tatha vidha shabda mukhena na lavanyadi shabda dvara eva dhvani pratitihi bhavati iti na anya mukhena prakarantarena va bhavet na tu lakshya shabda dvara or lakshaka shabda dvara. Yes?
So is he trying to say that wherever these words are used, these words don't give us the dhvani ever?
Yeah, they may not give you, because of their usage in the meaning of beauty, they will not give you. The other factors are contributing factors. This is not the one and only contributing factor.
So if let us say we take Lavanyam for example. If there's a shloka with Lavanyam, with the word Lavanyam in it, and the shloka has a very good dhvani in it, but we can't say that the dhvani is coming from this word. It is, yes, everything else that is contributing.
It is not, yes. So I can't say the dhvani is because lakshana mola dhvani. Because lavanyam is a rudi lakshana word and it does not mean lavana yuktam and it is only beauty. No, that is not the point. You should have that vibhava, anubhava or anything. Something or the other should be there. There should be a beautiful vastu from which another vastu is dhvanyate. That is how it can come.
Oh, just because this is a Rudi Hetu word.
Yes.
Oh, Rudi Mula Lakshana Shandaha. Okay.
So, Teshu cha Upacharita Shabda Vrittihi Asti. Teshu Lavanyadishu Shabdeshu Upacharita Shabda Vrittihi Asti. Tathavideya cha Vishaye Kvachit Sambhavannapi Dvani Vyavaharaha. Even though Dvani can occur in certain places where these words are present, prakarantarena pravartate, the actual dhani would be, or the vyanjaka shabda would be something else. Na tathavida shabda mukhena, you don't, lavanya can be a contributor, but not because it is a lakshana, and only through this lakshana we get that dhani. That's not the case. Next is shabdo naiva skalat gatihi. This is very important just to show the difference between how what happens in lakshana sthalam where there is a prayojanam. Mukhyam vrittim parityajya gunavrittya artha darshanam yad uddishya phalam tatra shabdo naiva skalat gatihi. The skalat gati is very important. See, skalat gati means badhaka vyaparena bodha jnanam. So where, from shabda you go, that shabda, the mukhyartham, there is a badham, and then only you go to the lakshyartham. Whereas the vyangyartha, pavanatvam, etc., you go directly from the shabdam. The moment I hear the word Ganga, I know it is pavanatvam. The moment I say Kabali Kovil, I know it is the pavanatvam is there for me. So the Kapali temple, the house is there in the temple. No, it is not near, it is actually near the temple, it is not inside the temple there. But the moment you hear the word temple, the prayojanam or the pavanatvam that comes to your mind is immediate from the word. So there is no skalat gati, there is no an intermediate step in that. There is no badha, mukhyartha badha there. So that's the idea in this karika. So mukhyam vrittim parityajya gunavrittya arthadarshanam mukhyam vrittim abhidavrittim parityajya gunavrittya lakshanaya arthasya darshanam is lakshyartha. You understand samipyam, because of samipyam you understand ganga tate ghoshaha and tatarupaha arthaha lakshanaya bhavati, because pravahe ghoshasya asatvat pravaha rupa mukhyarthasya badhaha bhavati. Next, this is for lakshana. Yad uddishya phalam, why are we using gangayam ghoshaha? For a phalam, for a prayojanam. What is that prayojanam? That is pavanatvam. To arrive at that pavanatvam, we do not go through this process. It is direct. So yad uddishya phalam tatra skalagatihi naiva bhavati, shabdaha skalagatihi na asti. That word is capable of conveying that prayojanam directly. So that's why we say the prayojanam is vyanjana, used through vyanjana vyapara. We are only talking about the difference between lakshana vyaparam and vyanjana vyaparam. We are not saying whether this is a dhvani sthalam or not. In dhvani, where it uses vyanjana vyapara, in lakshana, it uses lakshana vyaparam, right? So the vyaparam is different where there is a skalat gati. தடங்கல் இருக்குன்னு அர்த்தம். இட்ஸ் an obstacle, there is a, it's like an obstacle race. சொல்லு.
இது கைண்ட் ஆஃப் எனக்கு ஜஸ்ட் ஒரு மனசுல ஒண்ணு பிக்சர் வருது, இந்த மாதிரி இந்த ஸ்கலத் கத்தின்னு சொல்லி அது தடுக்கி தடுக்கி அப்படியே போய் ஒரு இடத்துல செட்டில் ஆயிடுறது. ஏன்னா அந்த லட்சியார்த்தம் ஒண்டிதான் ஃபிட் ஆகுறது இல்லையா?
ஆமா ஆமா,
அழகா இருக்குது. ஜஸ்ட்
அதுதான் இந்த ஸ்கலத் கத்தி இஸ் வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட்.
ஓகே,
ஈஸியர் டு ஃபிக்ஸ் இன் யுவர் மைண்ட் ஆல்சோ. So tatra hi charutva atishaya vishishtartha prakashana lakshane prayojane kartavye yadi shabdasya amukhyata tada dushtata eva tada tasya prayoge dushtata eva syat. Now if charutva atishaya vishishtartha prakashana lakshane prayojane kartavye, in lakshana moola dhvani, where that you want to bring about a prayojanam which is much more beautiful, charutva atishaya prakashanartham prayojane kartavye sati. When you want to, like in suvarna pushpam prithivi, the moment we say suvarna pushpam prithivim suvarnam pushpyati bhuhu prithivi suvarnam pushpayitum pushpyatum na shakyate. So that it is not possible for that earth to give forth suvarna pushpam. So what do you do? You the atishaya roopa charutvam, what is that? Which is samriddhi, someone who can extract a prosperity from this world, someone who can live in a prosperous manner in this world. So that is the idea when we get that, when we want to bring about a prayojanam which is much more beautiful than the words. If the poet does not give importance to the word, then it is a dosham. Yadi shabdasya amukhyata, shabdasya amukhyata chet tada tasya prayoge shabdasya prayoge dushtata eva syat. Yadi kavihi shabdasya mukhyatvam na dadati tarhi tatra dosha eva. Because it is only directly from the shabda that we get the prayojana, which is dhvani, which we get through vyanjana vyaparam. If the poet does not give pay attention to the shabdam, then he is actually making a mistake there.
Okay. Actually,
adu puriyala. Extra vadam solrar. This is not as an explanation of the karika. okay, the karika is over. Next explanation is, what is tatrahi ityukte dhvani vishaye yadi prayojane kartavye. If that prayojanam kartavye sati shabdasya amukhyatana ipo let me give that ex dvayam gatam samprati shochaniyatam, you know that shloka, yeah. Adhula vandu samagama prarthanaya kapalinaha, right? So okay, the word is important there to give us the meaning of akinchit. He doesn't have anything. Kapali saha tasya prarthanaya dvayam samprati shochaniyatam gatam. And edla, the word is very important in order to give me that prayojanam. What is the prayojanam for using that kapali? It is an auchityam dana yanga vanakku. And the word important illa, I can use any either kapali or pinaki. It doesn't matter. Both
okay,
are
okay. Okay, enna solla var, ipo puri artham.
Both are indicative of Shiva. I can use pinaki. But if I say he is pinaki, he is capable of conquering the whole world. So how come Parvati, by wanting to be with Shiva, she has gone into a pitiable state? It's not the case. Yeah, kapali na solraje, you want to be with a beggar and grammar dana solra. Then it makes sense. So the poet has to give in focus on the word also. If he doesn't focus and thinks that the word is amukhyam, then it is dushtata eva syat.
So there that kapali shabda is prayojanam and not that it is not the mukhyartha badha there, right?
No, there is no mukhyartha badha. Kapali is also Shiva, Pinaki is also Shiva. But there is an appropriety in the usage of kapali than Pinaki.
So that suggests the prayojanam part.
Yes.
Okay.
For a not prayojanam or not, it just suggests. It gives you that dhvani there. Because if you say prayojanam, then it means you're saying it is through lakshana. Then you'll say it is lakshana moladhvani. No, we don't want that there. Oh. I'm just so in case the poet wants to through in Suvarna Pushpam Prithivim, if he does not use Suvarna Pushpam and he just says some other, no, even Rajata Pushpam or something like that, he did not get the greatest prosperity in life. You could have, you know, instead of Suvarna Pushpam, if he had used Rajata Pushpam, the Shabdam is Mukhyam there.
Oh.
For the Prayojanam. If the poet does not pay attention to the Shabdam, then the Prayojanam is lost. He is not able to convey the correct Prayojanam.
Okay.
Okay. Next is the nacha evam tasmat. Nacha evam ityukte lakshanayam evam na asti. Nacha evam means in dvani. Sorry. In dvani evam na asti. Liya? Huh? Kurnam sha. I did not connect with it. Nacha prayoge dushtata kachit. Prayojanasya avignayanaiva pratitihi. Tasya shabda prayoge dushtata na kachit asti dvanistale. So dvanistale shabdasya dushtata na bhavati because we are able to understand that prayojanam. Tasmat. So what is the difference between lakshana vyaparam and dvani vyaparam? Vachakatva ashrayanaiva gunavrittihi vyavastita. That is your definition of lakshana. The first line. So vachakatva ashrayena. Gangayam ghoshaha, it is the, and you want the lakshyartham, which is the tateya ghoshaha. You use Ganga with a specific purpose, which is the prayojanam. You have that. So without the word, anga vandu vachakatva. So it is based on the abhidha vyaparam first, and then abhidha vyapara badhanena gunavrittihi. Then you go to the next word. So vachakatva ashrayenaiva kintu vyanjana vyaparayam vyanjakatva dhvanau vyanjakatva ekamulasya dhvanehe. We don't have anything else. Vachakatva ashrayam asti parantu gunavrittihi. So it is not based on that. We need Ganga for us to go to Ganga tata. In kasyavana bhavati rosho, if you think that, where is the idea of the cheti saying that I have, you know, I am the chaturyena tvam maya rakshita iti uktihi vachakatva ashrayam nasti. If the duti wants to convey, the friend, the sakhi wants to convey that she has cleverly saved the two of them in that Kasyavana Bhavati Rosho, none of those words are capable of giving that lakshyartham in or in intended meaning. It is only through vyanjaka vyaparam and the samskara vishesham that is there in our mind that we are able to understand, so that she beautifully has saved both of them, the nayika and the nayika. So vyanjakatva ekamulasya dvanehe syat lakshanam katham. Lakshanam katham means how can lakshana be a lakshanam definition for dvani, which is vyanjakatva mula, whereas lakshana gunavrittihi is vachakatva ashrita.
So ஆனந்த வர்தனர் இங்க வந்து வியஞ்சகத்துவ ஏக மூலக துவனின்னு சொல்லியிருக்காரு இல்லையா. ஆனந்த வர்தனர் வந்து இந்த லக்ஷணா மூல துவனி அபிதா மூல துவனின்னு சொல்றதெல்லாம் ஒத்துக்கிறது இல்லையா?
உண்டு உண்டு, கண்டிப்பா உண்டு, இருக்கு. வியஞ்சகத்துவ மூலம்னா லக்ஷ, ஈவன் இஃப் இட் இஸ் லக்ஷணா மூல துவனி, இட் ஸ்டில் ஹேஸ் அ வியஞ்சகத்துவம் ஆர் வியஞ்சனா வியாபாரம். Dhvani is there, no? It's on, the prayojanam is through that vyanjana vyaparam. That's what he said last in the last karika. Vyanjakatva moolam mangarche, it is vachakatva moolam, vachakatva ashrayena gunavrittihi vyavasthita. That is important. So from the vachaka, you go to the gunavritti. You use the lakshana, the vachakatva badham, vachyarthasya badha, and then gunavrittihi vyavasthita, it is established. Whereas directly from the vyanjaka, from the word, vachaka shabdena, or not vachaka, the terminology is different. There is a vachyartham there. Kasya roshaha na bhavati, drishtva, padma agrana shile. Where is the chaturyam there? Vachyarthamum illa. You're directly going to the vyangyartham in the mind. That's it. Gataha astam arkaha. What arrives in our mind? I have to do sandhya vandanam. I have to go cook. I have to bring my son from school. Where is the meaning connection between the two? So it is only vyanjakatvam. It's just a suggestion. Avlavadam, that's all he says. He doesn't deny abhidhamoolam or lakshanamoolam. Whether it is abhidhamoolam or lakshanamoolam, it has to have a suggestor. Either vachya, vachaka, bodhavya, kaku, edhu vanna nuduthukalame, prakaranam. அத்தனை ஒரு வியஞ்சகத்துவம் இருக்கே அங்க. லக்ஷணா பிகம்ஸ் எ வியஞ்சகத்துவம் தேர். இட் சீசஸ் டு பி அ லக்ஷக சப்த வென் யூ மூவ் டு த வெங்கியார்த்தம். இஃப் யூ வாண்ட் டு ஸ்டே வித் த லக்ஷார்த்தம், தென் ஹாப்பியா உட்கார்ந்துட்டு இருக்கலாம். சரி, வாசகத்துவ ஆசிரயேணைவ குணவிருத்தி வியவஸ்திதா வெஞ்சகத்துவ ஏகமூலஸ்ய த்வனேஹே ஸ்யாத் லக்ஷணம் கதம் இத்யுக்தே குணவிருத்தி த்வனேஹே லக்ஷணம் கதம் ஸ்யாத். ஹவு கேன் இட் பி? தஸ்மாத் அன்யா த்வனிஹி அன்யா ச குணவிருத்தி அவ்யாப்திரபி அஸ்ய லக்ஷணஸ்ய. அவ்யாப்தி மீன்ஸ் இன் சம் கேசஸ் லைக் இன் அவிவக்ஷித வாச்ச த்வனி. We saw the two examples. You remember those two examples, Suvarna Pushpam Prithvim and Shikarini Kvanu Nama. One is for Avivakshita Vachidvani, the other is Vivakshita Anyapara Vachidvani. So for Avivakshita Vachidvani, you may use Lakshana, even if there is Lakshana. It is only one of the different varieties of Dvani. Avyapti, wherever it does not exist. So Yatra, Yatra Dvanihi Asti, Tatra Bhaktihi Bhavitavya Iti Na Asti. So in some cases bhakti might be present. There may be other prakara or other divisions of dvani where bhakti or lakshana is not present. Dvani prabedaha vivakshita anyaparavachyaha lakshanaha na. Vivakshita anyaparavachya lakshana dvani prabede lakshana na vidyate iti avyaptihi lakshyaika desha vrittitvam. So avyapti means in the lakshya, which is dvani, Dvani ekadesha vrittitvameva lakshanayaha natu sampurnataya vyaptaha. So anyecha bahavaha prakaraha bhaktya vyapyantaha tasmat bhaktihi alakshanam. So there are anyecha bahavaha prakaraha bhaktya vyapyante tasmat. So only there are in vivakshita anyaparavachya dvani we have no lakshana there, whereas in avibhakshita vachadvani we have lakshana. So there may be other prakaras where lakshana can arise, but lakshana can never be a definition of dvani. Yatra yatra dvanihi tatra lakshana, yatra lakshana tatra dvanihi, you cannot say that. Okay, sorry. कस्यचित् ध्वनि प्रभेदस्य ध्वनि भेदस्य सातु स्यात् उपलक्षणम्. उपलक्षणम् मीन्स् जस्ट् एन् इण्डिकेटरी मार्क्. सो इफ् ऐ वाण्ट् टु से इफ् ऐ वाण्ट् टु पायिण्ट् औट् वेर् समन्स् हौस् इस् देर् आर् रो आफ् हौसस् से देवदत्तस्य गृहं कुत्र अस्ति. There are some 5 or 6 houses there. Someone is asking me from here. So I see all those houses. There is only one house where one crow is sitting. So I say, yatra kakaha upavishati tadeva devadattasya mandiram adava griham. So that kaka, the crow, is not going to be there always. It is only an upalakshanam. Kadachit bodhakaranam, natu sarvada bodhakaranam. So sometimes I can use lakshana to define dhvani, not always, not every time. So upalakshanam means it is not a definition, but just an indicatory factor. So kasyachit dvani prabhedasya sa lakshana upalakshanam syat sa punaha bhaktihi atava lakshana vakshyamana prabhedam adyat dvitiya udyote. In the second udyota he is going to talk about the divisions of dvani. In among all those prabhedas, अन्यतमस्य भेदस्य यदि नाम उपलक्षणतया सम्भाव्येत. यु इफ् यु वाण्ट् यु केन् यूस् इट् एस् एन् एक्स्ट्रा ऐडेण्टिफैयिङ्ग् मार्क्. जस्ट् सेयिङ्ग् दट् यु नो द वन् हू हेज़् अ मोल् आन् द फेस् इस् मै सन्, दट् इस् जस्ट् वन् आफ् दि अदर् इण्डिकेटर्. देर् मैट् बि 5 चिल्ड्रन् देर् हू हेव् अ मोल् आन् द फेस्. दट् केनाट् बि अ प्रापर् लक्षणं फार् दट् थिङ्ग्. So in that manner, yadi nama upalakshanataya sambhavyeta, you can probably have it as one of the indicatory factors for dhvani. Yadi cha gunavrittya eva dhvanihi lakshyate iti uchyate. If you say that dhvani is being defined only by lakshana, then तद् अभिधाव्यापारेण हि गिव्स् अ डिफ्रेण्ट् लैन् टु दिस् वाट् वी हव् आल्वेस् बीन् सेयिङ्ग् सि तद् अभिधाव्यापारेण तद् इतरः अलङ्कारवर्गः समग्रः एव लक्ष्यते इति प्रत्येकम् अलङ्काराणां लक्षणकरणवैयर्थप्रसङ्गात्. सो अभिधाव्यापारेण बै जस्ट् प्रैमरि मीनिङ्ग् वाच्य व्यापारेणैव इफ् यु से मुखमिव चन्द्रः, मुखमेव चन्द्रः, न मुखं चन्द्रः एव. So many ways in which I can get the meaning. Why do we need so many different alankaras? Tad itara abhidavyaparena itaraha alankara vargaha samagraha eva lakshyate. Just use abhidavyaparam, tell the meaning of those sentences. You don't need to define each and every alankara. You get what he is trying to say? It's completely tangential here. But what he is saying is something like upama shailushi eva. If you say that upama is present in most of the alankaras, pratipam, rupaka, apannuti, deepakam, all of nidarshana, everywhere there is rupakam. Why should I define it separately? Alankara prithakkarana vaiyarthyam atra lakshanakarana vaiyarthya prasangaha. I don't need to define so many different alankaras, 300 different alankaras. I can just stop with one. Upama, that is enough. There is a sadrishyam there in some manner or the other. And so he has just used, like in Vakrokti, he has just used a different way of saying things. That's all. Bhangyantarena. We don't need so many alankaras there. So yadi cha gunavrittya eva lakdvanihi. So lakshana alone is enough for me to define the entire set of dvani. I don't need dvani at all. If you say in that manner, then just a primary word and meaning is enough for me to describe the entire set of alankara varga. I don't need to do the definition, write out a definition and explain each and every alankara. Kincha lakshane anyaihi krite. I will just take a few minutes extra and finish it off. There are just a few more sentences. Maybe I'm rushing, I'm sorry, but it's not so tough to understand. So, Lakshane Anyaihi Krite Cha Asya Pakshasamsiddhirevanaha. In case someone before, Anyaihi Krite Sati, Lakshane Krite Sati, if someone else before me have defined, if they have in fact defined Dhvani, then Pakshasamsiddhirevanaha. Asmat Pakshasya Samsiddhihi, our view has been confirmed here. Naha naha asmakam pakshaha pakshasya samsiddhihi siddhihi successful. So whatever I have been trying to say is fine. If someone has explained it in some book that I have not encountered till now, there are so many books that we are unearthing today. If krite apiva purvameva, if someone has described it before, dvani lakshane anyaihi dvani lakshane krite api नः पक्षसंसिद्धिः एव यस्मात् ध्वनिः अस्ति इति नः पक्षः अस्माकं पक्षस्तु ध्वनिः अस्ति एव इति कारणात् अन्यैः लक्षणं कृतं चेत् अस्माकं सिद्धिरेव स च प्रागेव अयत्न स च प्रागेव संसिद्धः इति इट् हेस् बीन् एस्टाब्लिश्ड् बिफोर् इट् सेल्फ् इति अयत्न संपन्न समीहितार्थाः संवृत्ताः स्मः देन् वेरी एफर्ट्लेस्ली वी हैव गॉट व्हाट वी वांट समीहितार्थाः वी हैव अचीव्ड आवर पर्पस विदाउट एनी एफर्ट इफ समवन प्रागेव संसिद्धः यदि इफ इट हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड बिफोर बट इट हैज नॉट बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड सो आई एम स्टार्टिंग दिस दैट्स व्हाट आनंदवर्धना सेज The last paragraph here is the last vadam, alakshaniyatavada, where they say asti dvanihi, but it cannot be expressed in words. It is beyond words. Ye api sahridaya hridaya samvedyam anakhyeyam eva dvanehe atmanam amnasishuhu, those who have proclaimed dvanehe atmanam, that the dvani, the swarupam, atmanam is swarupam, the dvani swarupam, I have made a typo there, so please ignore. Ye api sahridaya hridaya samvedyam anakhyeyam. I've completely messed it up, sorry. Anakhya iyam iti. Dvanehe atmanam amnasishuhu. So some people have proclaimed, those who claim that it cannot be described, anakhyeyam, it cannot be described. And it is only sahridaya hridaya samvedyam. It is only known by the sahridaya in his mind. Iti amnasishuhu, te api na parikshakarinaha. They have not understood, they have not analyzed it completely. They have not put thought into their vadam. Their argument. So te api na parikshyavadinaha, they have not analyzed it without any thought they have spoken. Yataha uktya nitya vakshyamanaya nitya. Uktya nitya vakshyamanaya nitya. So you have to do that anvayam like that. So yataha uktya nitya vakshyamanaya cha dvanehe samanya vishesha lakshane pratipadite api. So uktya nitya What I have said before is the Samanya Lakshanam, which is Yatrartha Shabdova, Tamartham Upasarjani Krita Swartho, Vyankta Kavya Visheshas, Saddhani Viruti, Suribit Kathitaha. That is the Ukta Samanya Lakshanam, Ukta Niti. Then Vakshyamana Nitya is Vishesha Lakshanam, where he is going to talk about Arthantare Sankramitam, Atyantam Vatiraskritam, Avivakshita Vachyasya, Dvanehe Vachyam, Dvidhamatam. That is the first Karika in the second Udyotam. So Vakshyamana वक्ष्यमाणया नीत्या च ध्वनेः सामान्यलक्षणं विशेषणलक्षणं च प्रतिपादितं प्रतिपादिते अपि यदि अनाख्येयत्वं तत् सर्वेषामेव वस्तूनां तत् प्रसक्तम् इव इवन् आफ्टर् गिविङ्ग् द सामान्यलक्षणम् इन् विशेषलक्षणं यु स्टिल् कीप् वाण्ट् टु से दट् इट् इस् इन्डिस्क्रैबल् अनाख्येयम् ऐ केनाट् एक्स्प्रेस् हौ ध्वनि इस् ऐ केनाट् से एण्ड् मुकुलितलोचनैः नृत्यन्ति So that if you say that it cannot be described, that sarvesham eva vastunam tat prasaktam, then every object that has been described and the classification has been given till now, you can say the same thing. No, it cannot be described. सर्वेषामपि वस्तूनां यू केन् से द सेम् थिङ्ग् इट् वुड् अप्लै टु आल् थिङ्ग्स् इन् द वर्ल्ड् यदि पुनः ध्वनेः इफ् द अलक्षणीयता दट् इट् केनाट् बि डिस्क्रैब्ड् इट् इस् ओन्लि एन् अतिशयोक्ति इट् इस् अ हैपर्बोल् एक्स्प्रेशन् सो यदि पुनः ध्वनेः अतिशयोक्त्या अनया काव्यान्तर अतिशायि तैः स्वरूपम् आख्यायते if they by way of saying that it's alakshaniyam it cannot be described it is inexpressible if they are only actually trying to say in an atishayokti manner atishayoktya kavyantara atishayi kavyeshu kavya vibhageshu atishayi it is the best among it is superior to any of the parts of the kavyam it's it is superior concept in a kavyam स्वरूपम् आख्यायते तैः इफ् दोस् अलक्षणीयतावादी आर् आक्चुली ट्रैङ्ग् टु से दट् ध्वनि ईस् द मोस्ट् सुपीरियर् इन् द काव्यं बै गिविङ्ग् इट् सच् अन् अतिशयोक्ति दट् इट् इस् इन्एक्स्प्रेसिबल् तत् ते अपि युक्त अभिधायिनः एव देन् दट् इस् द ट्रूत् युक्तमेव उक्तं तैः वाट् दे हेव् सेड् इस् कम्प्लीट्लि ट्रू बिकास् ध्वनि एक्सिस्ट् सो ही स्टार्टेड् आफ् वित् गिविङ्ग् द मिस्कन्सेप्शन्स् आफ् ध्वनि where abhavavadi matam and then he went to those who said bhaktireva lakshana bhaktireva dvanihi and then alakshaniyata it cannot be expressed so he has refuted all the different paksha and he has established that dvani exists and it can be defined and he has given the definition of dvani also here in the second udyotam he is going to give the classifications okay